Lower Primary, we are back! We've had our break, we're feeling rested, and it is time to get back involved in performing arts with me, Mrs. Bates. And we are continuing with our theme of around the world. That is a tune that was out before you were born. So we've got three new countries to look at today. And I don't know if you heard, but word on the street is there is a sea shanty competition that is going on in these very lessons, and someone is going to win 50 house points, and their winning entry will be posted on all of school's social media. Maybe your teachers have told you about it. Maybe you've seen the posters hanging around school. I'm going to help you with that as well. But before we do, we are going to dance. We're going to move around the order a little bit. So we're going to do dance, then drama, then music this time, just to keep mixing it up. You never know what's coming. So have you got a hair tied back? No, but I'll do it in a second. Comfy clothes on, lots of space to move, and water nearby. Let's crack on. All right, Lower Primary. So before we start dancing, let's find out a little bit more about the topic that I've chosen for us this half term. So the country we will be exploring in dance is the United States of America. And there is the Stars and Stripes, which is of course where we are right now. And here's our map. Can anyone see us? Because it's cut us off. We're like there somewhere, and there's the beginning of Virginia. We're like bloop, bloop, something like that. So this is going to be a dance style that originated right here in the USA, and it is tap dancing. Woo! I don't know why none of this is coming up in a good order. Maybe I didn't sort that, I thought I had. But anyway, so it is the original home of tap dancing, if anyone's tried this before, and we are gonna be doing some tap. Now, before we go any further, you can see the shoes are kind of different, and you make tappy sounds with your feet because they've got metal on the special shoes. There's no pressure at all, obviously, to get any, but if you have some tap shoes at home, I would really recommend you dig them out and put them on for these lessons. If you don't have any, you can use like a kitchen floor, like a hardwood floor, and have some like solid, sturdy shoes on to try and make a little bit of sound. Okie dokie, let's find out. Oh, I did decide to do the animations. These are the shoes here. So tap dance facts. Tap dance is a fusion of African percussion and Irish clog dancing. We've talked about this before, how incredible immigration is. And when people move from different countries, they take their flavors and their culture and their style. And that's how we get incredible pieces of music and dance and food, because people put their little bits of taste in and then they take a little bit from new places, and it all sort of, I don't know, goes in a big melting pot together and comes out with something cool like tap dance. So we had African people that brought their percussions and their rhythms. Rhythm's super important. And then the Irish came over with clog dancing, which is a different type of dance with hard shoes. And they went in the melting pot together. And now we have tap dance. So it started in the 1900s. So quite a long time ago, but not as old as ballet that we did last time. It is newer than ballet. Tap shoes are very important to help make different sounds. So they first used to be made of wood with pennies attached to the heels. I mean, I was going to say, if you can think of some way of doing that, another arts and crafts project, I don't know, but don't wreck your shoes. And then now they have metal taps on the bottom, and I have mine. I haven't got them on yet, still got my trainers on because I'm talking, but I'll get changed before we start moving and I will have my tap shoes on for you. Tap was often performed alongside jazz music. We haven't looked at any jazz yet, have we? But it's a type of music. And then it became popular in musical theatre. Well, we all know we've looked at that. And also later on in Hollywood movies. So if you watch really old movies, you might see some tap dance numbers in there. And also if you go to the theatre, because they're all open, aren't they? Not. Next time we ever get to go to the theatre, or if you watch any musicals on TV, you might see some tap numbers in them. So that's enough of me talking. I think it's time to tap, people. Try and find some like solidy shoes. A hardwood floor would be good. I'm gonna change my shoes and I'll see you when I've got some more space. All right, team, here I am. And as you can hear and maybe see, I have got my tap shoes on, ready to rock. So you can see there is a metal tap on the bottom, on my ball of my foot, and a metal tap on the heel. So there are a lot of sounds we can make with these shoes, and we're going to be learning a new move every day. So I'm just going to teach you a little warm-up exercise today, actually, that we'll do at the beginning of every lesson to get our feet warm. Knees, legs are super, super important, and just get us, our brains working in tap mode, I guess. And then from Thursday's lesson, I'm going to teach you a new move every week that we can put into a routine like we did with ballet, yeah? So we kind of learned a move and then we added it onto our dance and we had our fabulous conga dance by the end of the week. That was a bit of a feeble throw, wasn't it? Anyway, so we can see on the board what our warm-up is. Hop, jump, hop, jump, jump in, out, in, clap, flap, hit, flap, hit, flap, flap, clap. I would think you would know what all of those moves are except for a flap. That is a new tap move we're going to look at today. So let's put these moves into practice. So to warm us up, we're going to do a hop, and then we're going to do a jump, feet apart. Then we're going to do it on the other side, hop, jump. And then it says we go in, out, in, clap. In, out, in, clap. Now I'm trying on the jumps to keep my heels a tiny bit off the floor, bend the knees, so we don't have like messy sounds. It's only the balls of the feet that are making the sound, okay? Nice and light and bouncy. So hop, jump, in, out, in, clap. Let's give that a try, team. 5, 6, 7, and a hop, jump, hop, jump, in, out, in, clap. Yeah, one more time. 5, 6, hop we go. Hop, jump, in, out, in, clap. What are you buzzing for? I'm in the zone, apparently. Right, then, a flap. Now, how do I explain a flap? It is all with the toe. No heel again. Keep the heel off. You're going to brush the foot forward and then tap it on the floor. Four tap, four tap, four tap. It kind of feels like wobbly jelly in your thighs, especially mine. And then you go faster, faster. So you go, keep it low to the ground. Boom. Four tap, four tap. Let's try the other leg. So slowly first, forward hit, forward hit. So you're brushing it forward and tapping that toe down. Keep that heel up. Ba-dum. Oh, that was a bad one. Ba-dum. 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 Try not to do that scrape on the way up. That was a bad example as well. So when it says hit, we're just going to tap our sides. So it says flap, hit, flap, hit, flap, flap, flap. That looks like this. Alright, so kind of like you're walking down the street in a really weird way. Let me show you that from the side. It goes, clap, hit, clap, hit, clap, clap, clap. And did you notice my heels didn't touch the ground? So we have to be really careful, because as soon as they touch the ground, the world knows. It's like having a foghorn on your heel. Every time you put it down, everyone's going to hear. So you have to keep them up and have thighs of steel. Clap, hit, clap. Dodgy one at the end. We all make dodgy ones, but we have to practice. So that is going to be our warm-up team. So let's just think about that again. It says hop, jump, in, out, in, clap, flap, hit, flap, hit, flap, flap, flap. And then we can go on the other side. Bam, bam. It'll be that foot. One, two, three. Let's try it without the music first, and then we've got some funky American music to have a little try to, all right? So hop, jump, here we go. 5, 6, 7, we go. Hop, jump, hop, jump, hop, hop, hop. That's not a hop, flap, wasn't it? I was saying hop and it wasn't a hop. Let's try starting with the other leg. 5, 6, 7, 8, go. Hop, out, hop, out, in, out, in, clap, clap, hit, clap, hit, clap, clap, clap. Okie dokie. And of course, what you can do with this one, once you're happy with it, you can start taking it wherever you want. That's kind of a hopscotch, isn't it? Yeah, and we can travel it around. Let's try it with the music, just doing it straight, and then we've run out of time already. Oh my goodness. I'll keep right back and see if I can just do it 2 times, all right? So right leg, or maybe your left leg, and then the other leg, all right? Let's have a try with our funky music. Right. So go, hop, jump in and in. Feel that beat. Hop, six. My goodness, what a job to have, eh? Clams most often represent an everyday person who makes simple mistakes just like everybody else, and that's what makes them comedy. All right, so it's not really about being a highly intelligent or a rich person or anyone that stands out. It's an everyday normal person that just makes clowns of themselves, makes little mistakes that people find funny because they can kind of relate to it and think, oh my goodness. Okay, so that is our clowning facts. Now, this week, today's lesson and Thursday's lesson is going to be called I Wonder. And here's our clown thinking, So the first skill that we're going to explore is using our facial expressions. And of course, this is something that was taken off us in our mask work, wasn't it? So it's kind of good to start there, I think, because they've been asleep since musical theatre, haven't they? They've been dormant since Christmas. So just as we couldn't use our voices in the mask work, we weren't allowed to talk, clowning is exactly the same. Still no talking, they do not talk. So we have to show all our feelings with our bodies. And this week, we are going to work on the element of surprise! Surprise, and how we show that with our face. So I'm going to back the camera up a little bit because I need a little bit more space for our first activity. I will see you in a new spot in a second. All right, everyone, I have traveled long and far to the floor for our first activity. So you can see in front of me, I have 1, 2, 3 containers, okay? Now, let's think of some possible questions we might ask about these containers. What are you wondering right now? Have a moment to think. What's in your mind about these containers? What are you thinking? Let's have a look at some possible questions. Where did they come from? They weren't there when we just did tap. So where have I just got these from? Why are they different sizes? These are kind of similar, but they're a little bit different because this one was narrower at the top and this is wide all the way along. So why are they different sizes? That could be a question we might want to know about. Who brought them here? Who did this? Was it? Why is there suddenly some containers there? What's inside them? So they're upside down, aren't they? So we can't see, but there might be something underneath. So the really interesting question, I think, maybe this is what you thought, what's inside them? What's going on? So we're going to have a think about what might be inside of them. So think about this, knees aren't working for me, I'm afraid. So have a think. Think of a list of things that could potentially be inside them. And don't forget the size of them. So it's not going to be like a full-size car, is it? Right? So have a think. Name some things, maybe you're with a sibling or a family member. Or you can just do it in your mind. What might be inside these containers? I bet you thought of loads of ideas of things that could be. It could just be anything that fits inside, couldn't it? Now, here's a question for you. What would really surprise you if it was inside? Think of something where you'd be like, what would be really cause some surprise in any of the containers? All right, so as I said, we are going to be working on facial expressions and also the element of surprise. So we haven't got masks on anymore, so our faces can tell our stories, but our voices can't when we're being a clown. So we need to show surprise on our faces. Let's pretend we are each holding one of these boxes. So maybe you've got a box at home that you'd like to try, or a container at home that you'd like to do this with. Or you can just pretend. We're really good at miming, right? So you can pretend you've got a box in front of you. We are going to carefully peek inside one of the boxes, and I'm going to tell you what's in there, and can you show me with your face how that's going to be? So I'm going to name an item. You've got to pretend it's in the box without talking and using only your face. Show me how you would show your surprise. Okay. So I'm going to go for, I'm going to move these two out of the way. I'm going to pick this green one, all right? So I'm going to lift it up and pretend what's inside. I'll let you know, okay? So the first thing we're going to pretend is a chocolate cupcake. So lift up your box and show with your face what you would do if there was a really big, from Sprinkles as well, chocolate cupcake. Alright, remember all those facial expressions. So maybe you want to eat it. Run out of time. Maybe you want to eat it. Maybe your eyes widen because you're so hungry. You can just imagine it. You can smell it. Let's try one more and then we'll continue with this on Thursday, okay? This time in your box, there's a mouse. Oh my goodness, what are we going to do? Right, ready? So you're going to lift up your box and show me with your face what would happen if there was a mouse. Ready? Can you tell I'm frightened of animals? Wow, is it a live mouse in there? I think I might have just chopped off its head or something. I was a bit violent there, wasn't I? I think I was a clown that didn't really like mice, to be honest with you. I'm a little bit scared. All right, guys. So hopefully you saw a completely different reaction. And next time, because we've run out of time, on Thursday, bring your box. We are going to have a look at some more items that might be in the box. And we're actually going to watch some professional clowns and see how they do it. But for now, people, it's the time we've all been waiting for. Let's find out about this competition in music. All right, lower primary musos, you did an awesome job last half term with our Senegalese drums, and I know that because some of you sent me in your videos looking rather fabulous with all your triplets and your calls and responses and your steady beats, and it was amazing. So let's find out where we will virtually fly to for music this half term. And it is in fact ye olde British Isles. Hey-ho! So, this might look a little bit weird, and it is a little bit weird. Do you know what it is, people? I had this around the world idea ages ago, and then I think I'll just pick a country where something's from. Why is it so difficult to find out where something's from? Clowning might be Egypt. We think it's Egypt, but then it was loads of other places, so we're not quite sure. That's annoying. Ballet, well, it's, everything's in French, but it was kind of from Italy, but then it moved to France. Just tell me. Country! So again, with this theme, we are leaning to the British Isles. I have put the Union Jack, the United Kingdom, and the Republic of Ireland flag, and even a little map to tell myself, because I get ever so confused with the difference between the United Kingdom and Great Britain and the British Isles. As a grown-up, I'm like, what's the difference? But apparently, according to this, the British Isles is all of it. So England, Wales, Scotland, Northern Ireland, and the Republic of Ireland. And all of these places combined, we think, there's just no guarantees, is the home of, most likely, say, I'm not committing, don't sue, sea shanties! Roar, roar. So, Mrs. Taylor of PE fame messaged me, Mrs. Bates, the world's gone sea shanty crazy. TikTok, I haven't got it, Mrs. Taylor. Instagram, I haven't got it, Mrs. Taylor. Old school, you know? It's full of sea shanties. It's all the rage. Performing arts need to get on this ASAP. Yes, Mr. Taylor, that's exactly what I'll do. I will teach myself what a sea shanty is, and then I will relay that information to you. And not just that, we're going to make it a competition, people. We're going to get involved. So, you've got some clues. I mean, sea is giving something away. But this is going to be about sea shanties. And you guys that are much hipper and cooler than me have potentially already seen these all over YouTube and TikTok and all the rest of it. Let's get some facts. What on earth is a sea shanty? Well, this is what I learned over half term. Although nobody knows for sure where it began, because that would be too easy. It is thought that sea shanties started in the 1400s. I feel like I should have some sort of timeline, because I just chuck years at you and it's like, what? So the 1400s, we're thinking like 500 years before tap dancing, so older than tap dancing, but like still 3,000 years younger than climbing. So it's somewhere in the middle, but it's old, so that's all you need to know. They were sung by sailors working on the tall ships, and it helped them to pass the time during hard manual tasks. So they're songs that are sung by sailors to help them make a task a bit more exciting, you know? There would often be one sailor who would start the song and the rest would sing after, which is called, we know this, it happens in Senegal, call and response. Who knew? It happened in the 1400s as well. So one head sailor sings and the others respond. Sea shanties are currently a huge trend online. Ask your grown-up whether they can find any examples of modern-day sea shanties on TikTok if they're cooler than me and own TikTok. I'm sure everybody in the world apart from me has TikTok. But they are also on YouTube as well. So you can have a little bit of look for inspiration. Why would you need inspiration, you ask? Because it's competition time. I have created a BISW primary competition. Let's find out a bit more about it. So, BISW are holding a sea shanty competition for primary students only. Got to be in it to win it, people. It's got to be one of you right now watching this video that is going to win. What are you going to win? Only 50 house points. And your video will be posted on school's social media. I am offering you worldwide internet fame and 50 house points for the best sea shanty. So tune in to each of these lessons to learn how to write and perform your own original sea shanty. So every week I'm going to give you some helpful hints and tips, tell you a little bit more about it already, we know quite a lot about it, and then on show day, film yourself with your original sea shanty that you've written and you've sing, and send to me to be in with a chance to win this once-in-a-lifetime prize. Tempted? I can see you thinking about it. Couple of things. You can have siblings involved. You can have families involved. I don't mind. It doesn't have to be one person on their own. Obviously, it has to be COVID friendly. But if you want to write one with your friend and someone in your family is good at video editing and can stick you both together, that's cool. Do it with a brother or sister. Do it with a mum or dad. Do it, get the whole family involved. Write and perform a sea shanty and send to me before, I think I've put April the 9th, which is the last day of this term before the Easter holidays. Send that to me and the winner will be announced shortly. Amazing. So, let's get going. Today we are going to look at some of the common patterns that are in sea shanties so we know where we need to start. All right? So, most sea shanties have a really strong, steady beat. So, the first thing you're going to need is your beat. And you're going to need to choose your tempo, which is your speed. So, I've got an example for you. We're going to try and clap along. And it says underneath, can you hear the triplets? Isn't it just incredible that, like, these things just keep cropping up from all around the world, but they're kind of the same thing? But it'll sound very different to Senegal. So, let's have a listen to this classic sea shanty that I was 3 days ago old when I heard. And let's see if we can clap to the beat. Boop, 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 boop.
I'd sing you a song, oh, the fish, oh, the sea.
Hear that beat?
Hey, hey, blow and young sailor man, listen to me. Oh, give us some time to blow the man down. Now first came the herring, saying I'm king of the sea.
Hey,
hey, blow the man down. He jumped on the poop, oh, the captain of the. Oh, give us some time to blow the man down. Next came the flat,
yes?
They call him escape. Be the captain, well then I'm the mate. Oh, give us some time to blow the man down.
All right.
Next came the hecky, was black as a rook.
So that is the perfect example of a sea shanty, isn't it? It's got everything we've described. Steady beat, tick. It's got the call and response, tick. If you're doing this on your own, don't, obviously then you can't physically do the call and response. You'll just have to respond to yourself. Are you kind of having a conversation with yourself? That's fine. But that is what's really common in a sea shanty. Now, very quickly, where am I? I'm going to tell you of three different types of sea shanty, and then it will be you to have a think about which one you're going to go for, all right? So the speed and tempo of the songs change depending on which task they were written to accompany. So I've got three examples. I've probably only got time to, we'll do the first one today and then we'll have a little look at the others on Thursday, okay? And it's actually the song that we've just listened to. So the first example is called a long haul shanty, and that's for heavy moving. So basically what the sailors would do is, because it was helping them with jobs, it's got to be the same pace, all right? So let's pretend to do some sort of heavy moving. Let's do... what could be heavy on it? Let's just pretend, pick something up and pull it down. Boom, we're pretending we're moving things like on a cargo from one person to another, okay? So this song has to match the tempo. Let's go back to that song and pretend to move a box from one side to the other, kind of like we're passing it in a big line of workers.
Hey, hey, blow the man down.
Says he, I'm no sailor, I'll ship as the cook.
Oh, give us some time to blow the man down.
Next came the shab with his two rows of teeth.
Way, hey, blow the man down.
Cook, mind you, the cabbage and not
yes.
Mind the beef.
Oh, give us.
So that was supposed to help the sailors just to make the time pass. You know, like if you've got a bit of a boring, rubbish job, you just have a little sing. I mean, I know I do that. So that is one type. We have run out of time, but heavy moving is a long haul shanty. I will on Thursday show you the next two and then your first task that you need to think about before you write your own. Hopefully you've learned a little bit more about it. Do a little bit of research if you want to, and come back on Thursday to find out a little bit more that can help you. But for now, we are at the end of our lesson, everybody. Thanks so much for joining, as always, and I'll see you on Thursday.